is Divinity Rocks. It's the end of a decade, the start of an era. My mama named me Debbie, my teachers called me Deborah. God told me, girl, you were sister for infinity. You ain't from this earth, they should call you Divinity. And you can call.
So I'm from Atlanta, Georgia. I started playing bass when I was 20 years old. I started in college at UC Berkeley. I went to school to become a journalist, and I ended up a bass player. Who knew? But at that time, I just fell in love with the bass guitar. I would go home every day and just play bass. My very first tour was with Victor Wooten, incredible bass player. I went to his bass camp, and the first time you have to introduce yourself by playing bass. And I'm gonna play for you what I played for him.
Yo, it's the D-I-V-I-N-I-T-Y. You wanna be I, baby, you can't see I-D-I-V-I-N-I-T-Y. Somebody say, ow. D-I-V-I-N-I-T-Y. You wanna be I, baby, you can't see I-D-I-V-I-N-I-T-Y. Somebody say, ow. I drop bombs like torpedoes. I smack biters like mosquitoes. I get up on the mic and we know that thing go great out. I rock rhymes with a show on my hands. My lyrics all spirit in my big girl stands. I'm from the city where we don't dance. All we do is this with the mic in our hand. MC is for mind control, and I can tell when you bust that you're striking a pose. But you better hold on to your soul, cause you just might need it when it's time to roll. D-I-V-I-N-I-T-Y. You wanna be I, baby, you can't see I. D-I-V-I-N-I-T-Y. Somebody say ow. That was the very first song I wrote on bass guitar. And when Victor asked us to introduce ourselves, that's what I played. And then he asked me to go on tour with him. So I toured with Victor Wooten for 5 years. And then I heard that Beyonce was having auditions for an all-female band. But I didn't want to do the audition for Beyonce, but my friends convinced me that it was a good idea. So I went to the audition. And I got the gig. Very cool.
Some people are born to lead and others are born to follow. Some people are born to spit it, others are born to swallow. Some are born to make the rules, others are born to break it. Some people are born to dish it, others are born to take it. I was born to make this better, but never, however, never will I. Let them take me, let them make me, cause I know it's a lie. I'm a rebel when I'm writing, say we monsters inside. Inside, inside, inside.
She was very graceful in allowing us the opportunity as musicians to come out and give solos, you know. A lot of big artists don't do that, you know. So that was really an incredible experience. It was scary. Oh, it was very scary to come out on stage in front of thousands of people with just the bass guitar. And I said, well, what am I gonna do? And you know, then I had the idea to play some of my favorite bass lines, some of my favorite hip-hop bass lines, especially growing up in Atlanta. A lot of the music is bass influenced, you know, like Outkast. I didn't have the mic though. Me and you, your mama and your cousin too. Rolling down the strip on Bogues, coming up slamming Cadillac doors.
You know, that stuff was like so deeply ingrained in me, so I said, hey, that's what I want to, you know, that's what I want to do. So I think people are paying more attention to musicians nowadays. I have several influences. Of course, Victor Wooten is probably my biggest influence on bass. Marcus Miller was a really big deal. Of course, Bootsy Collins, Larry Graham. I grew up listening to a lot of hip-hop music, so that's a huge influence on me as well. That's where the rhyming comes from. Everybody from The Roots and Black Thought and, of course, KRS-One and De La Soul and, you know, just all the popular hip-hop music. MC Light was a big influence.
It was
it was all about the funk. You know, it was all about funk and party and go, 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 rah, 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 you know, and a bunch of... You know, it was all about just slapping and popping and having a good time for me. Because I've been able to play with a lot of my heroes. I've played with Victor. I've played with Marcus. I've played with Bootsy. Bootsy and I. Bootsy is on my album, so that's really cool. I wish I could have been Bob Marley's bass player. Seriously, the bass was so important to his music, and just that groove and that funk. I would have liked to come up during that time. I'm gonna tell you about a dream I had. I had this dream that Jimi Hendrix needed, wasn't gonna make it to the stage. And they came to me and said, "Divinity, you have to go on stage and play for Jimi Hendrix right now." And I was like, "I play the bass, I don't play the guitar." You know? I'm about to jump, I'm about to give you what you want. The phone, I got a trick up my sleeve and a handful of trunk. We about to run the Boston for your heartbeat. Far from the dirty south, we're up dirty mouth. You step into my house and you might not get out. So get out, it ain't no other way. 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 Push it, push it, push it. Jumping around.
Yeah.
Now I'm like, you know, there are quite a few. When I first started playing, I used to just do finger to fret. And then this guy told me this really cool exercise where you alternate fingers. So you might start like this, and then, or you go down, and then you go, so you start on two. It's like a one, two, three, four, then two, one, three, four, then two, three, one, four, and then two, four, one, three. And you just do these. And it's boring. It's not fun. It's not fun. It's really not. There's a lot of not fun stuff that comes with playing, you know, or just playing your three notes to a string. Jaco really, really talked about that, because when you play three notes to a string, you're allowed, you cover much more of the bass as opposed to playing a major scale like this, you know, with two notes. But the cool thing that I told the kid is to make it fun. You know, then it's not so boring. You got it right. I said, hit me on a 2.5. sometimes I sit around and do this. It's called The Rocks Box Experience. It's rock and hip hop. A few of those songs that we did, yeah, Get Here is gonna be on the album. I'm pretty much an independent artist. I'm pressing my own CDs, paying for my own studio time. Don't have a record label. You see, wildflowers don't know that they ain't supposed to grow. So they grow all over your soul, all over your soul. So they grow.
Continue to love each other and to grow and be creative and don't take the arts out of school. If we can love each other, then we would probably wouldn't see so much war and so much destruction in the world. And if we play more music, the world would be a greater place. How about that?
Thank you. I want to give a special shout out to all of you incredible people who made this production happen. Thank you so much. Thank you for coming and asking questions and hanging out. And especially to John.